So I'm currently 10-0 in ranked season, still undefeated, looking for that first L. I'm also only 259 points away from making World Series. I've got Andrew McCutchen, this hyper series, making his debut for me today. Have him in center field, also leading off in my lineup. And seeing the price of Ernie Banks at 27.32 and then Randy Johnson 30,034, that's making me feel like, is it even worth it, the stress to try to make World Series only 9 days left in the season when I'm recording this? To start, I've got Babe Ruth on the mound. We're going to be the away team, so we hit first, but I have not allowed a base runner yet with Babe Ruth. I think he's thrown 12 or 13 innings. Zero base runners allowed. Looking to stay perfect today. Looking to have a good debut from McCutchen today. And my first debut with Cutch. Good timing, but we chased a pitch out of the zone. I hope it gets down. Babe lining out for out number two. If we can have good swings, though, the hits, the runs, they should start coming. Mike Trout batting 534 for me this year. He'd be the perfect guy to start a two-out rally. Oh, we missed it with Trout, I think. Just no, it's gone. Wow. Yeah, Mike Trout has probably been my favorite card this year. He was by far and still is the best diamond I've packed this year. That's 19 homers, getting even closer to being super fractured. Might have to do a plane until I super fractor a card video coming up here soon, but he's already given us a lead. Oh, please get through, and it does. Rafael Palmeiro maybe keeps this two-out rally going. A homer, now a single, and Mookie Betts is coming up. As y'all might know, he literally either hits a home run for me or doesn't do anything. So I'm praying that Mookie hits a two-run homer right here. And Mookie just misses a homer. Hanging splitter, good timing, PCI. I've been doing this a lot recently, a little bit too far beneath the ball, but we took a lead. Let's see if we can hold on to it. Babe Ruth has not allowed a base runner in his first two games for me on the mound. I would love that to somehow be three in a row. And there is the first base runner I've allowed with Babe Ruth this year. All right, I don't want to say it's a weight off my shoulders, but now that's like an extra stress that I don't have. I'm not trying to stay perfect with Babe anymore, but with that leadoff double in scoring position, now I'm a little bit stressed trying to keep my lead. Joe Mauer. Oh, that's some weak contact. Let's see how Cutch's arm is in the outfield. I messed up the perfect throw. We wouldn't have had him anyways. Just like that, we're tied at one. And Correa hits it to right. Trout should get there. That's out number one. Bryce Harper is supercharged. Lefty-lefty just misses a two-run shot. And we're one out away from keeping this game tied. And there we go. Besides the run allowed, not that bad of an inning for Babe. No longer perfect. A little bit of a weight off my shoulders, I guess. Tied at one. After one, looking to take my lead back. One of my favorite cards this year, this Christian Yelich from the Easter Egg Hunt program. He's been doing great. Looking to still do great here today. 4.59 average. Oh my goodness. Christian Yelich is a bad man. I'm loving this card from the Egg Hunt program. Perfect on the outside corner. 2-1, his sixth of the year. We took the lead back just like that. Corey Seager had three home run distance but foul swings, including one with good timing. And then I go and do that for out number one. We've had a lot of good swings off of John Smoltz. I just got to try to keep it fair. I'm batting 6-11 with Mike Pizza, but I still don't have my first home run with this card. And I still don't have my first home run with this card. Another good swing, though. We're really smacking the ball hard off of John Smoltz today. Oh, my goodness. Freddie Freeman might have hit a 500-foot homer. Hanging splitter. We kept that one fair. Let's see the distance in the bottom right. Makes it 3-1. 479. I think he hit it further than that. I really do. And it's time for Andrew McCutchen making his debut to get his second at-bat here in the second inning. I'm glad we laid off that one. And Cutch lines over the head of Yelich for his first base hit. 100 miles an hour off the bat, and he's in scoring position with 2 outs. His swing's feeling good again. And Babe goes yard. I don't think this one will be 500 feet. I don't think it will be 479. Maybe, though. I mean, that's max power. That traveled for... I thought it was going to be in the bullpen. 490 from Babe. Giving himself some more comfort on the mound. Our third home run of the inning, and it's 5-1 in inning number two. And then Trout is early. That's probably my sixth or seventh swing that would have been a homer if I just had good timing this game. And then we strike out on the slider away, but not a bad inning. One batter, one out. for Babe Ruth. Left it pretty much down the middle to Yelich, but he got on top of the sinker. Back-to-back pitches, back-to-back outs. And that's a much better bottom of the second than a bottom of the first for Babe on the mound. I'm sad that we gave up the first run with him, first hit, first base runner, but it was bound to happen eventually. And now we just want to add on to this lead following a scoreless inning. That's such a bad swing. Hanging splitter, PCI, nowhere near the ball. And Mookie only hits homers for me. It's either that or he gets out. And that one actually might be 500 feet. I think in the completing the season awards program, he had a 550. That is 501 from Mookie Betts. We're just smashing the baseball off of John Smoltz today, man. This is feeling good. Another perfect, another home run for us. And speaking of, Yelich had one in his last AB, a perfect homer on an outside pitch. Let's try to get his second homer of the day. And he gets his second homer of the day. His second perfect of the day. John Smoltz is not fooling anybody. April Fool's Day was a few days ago, and I think he would have missed it then. Seven homers on the year for Yelly. His second homer of the game. 7-1 in the top of the third inning. And when it rains, it pours. I'll tell you.
What?
8-1. Another home run. We've hit back-to-back-to-back homers. Mike Piazza, still, I think, the only guy in my lineup without a home run this year. If he could get his first one right here, that'd be four homers in a row. And it's not my first homer with Mike Piazza. Pretty good swing, and it gets down. So he gets a base hit, but our home run streak is gone. And McCutchen is on deck. Let's try not to hit into a double play before he comes up. Oh, that's ball four to Freddie Freeman. My bad, I fell asleep. He wasn't throwing me any strikes. McCutchen's coming up 1-for-2 with a double. Let's try to get his first homer. I guess he and Mike Piazza both don't have homers. My opponent brings in super fractured Satchel Paige in relief of John Smoltz here in the third inning. And then we get jammed with McCutchen. Yeah, 102 is a little bit faster than whatever Smoltz was throwing. Let's try to start a two-out rally. Babe Ruth now facing Satchel Paige. Two on, two down. We've already got a seven-run lead. He's already got a two-run homer in this game. And Babe, I thought he went yard. That's good timing. Sinker, but we just didn't move the PCI to the ball. So warning track power. Pretty good inning for us. I think we had three homers, a few hits. And I'm hoping Babe can just hold on to the lead. Keep it where it's at. One pitch. And that's one out in the bottom of the third. And Babe strikes out Dylan Cruz. I will say that Dylan Cruz card, I think he's from the spring breakout program, if I'm not mistaken. He has a really good swing. I know y'all have been telling me in the comments you like Dylan Cruz. I've used him a little bit. I don't know if I've used him online besides in events, but in events and in Conquest, his swing was feeling real good. On our way to the fourth inning, Satchel Paige on the mound now in replace of John Smoltz, and we have an 8-1 lead, looking to add on to it, looking to swing a little bit earlier on his triple-digit fastball. That was a weird-looking swing. And Rafael Palmeiro, perfect on the sinker inside. That one might be 500 feet, 9-1, two runs in a scoreless inning away from a mercy rule, his first of the year. Oh, he didn't have a homer for me either. But now, it's Mike Trout and Andrew McCutchen. He hits at 477, and we lead by 8. And Mookie hits his second homer of the game. His first one was 501 feet. Let's see if he can beat that right here, making it 10-1, 449, not even close. But speaking of homers, Yelich already has... Does he have two in this game? I think he has two in this game. I thought he had three early on that pitch. Otherwise, it would have been his third homer of the game. And then we swing at that one. I tried to check it, but pressed the button down a little bit too hard. Our final hope to be able to go for a mercy rule in the bottom of the fourth is going to be Corey Seager. Oh, if he had a little bit more power or if he had good timing. No, it's gone! So we're 3 outs away from another mercy rule following another home run. His 8th of the year. I think maybe his 2nd of the game. Yo, Mr. Mike Piazza, I'm begging you, man. I'm going to get down on my hands and knees right now to try to get you your first home run of the year. I'm literally begging. And good timing, 102 mile an hour fastball, PCI just below the ball, just missed that one. But we're 3 ounces away from another mercy rule. 11 runs, 13 hits, I don't even know how many homers, and our first 4 innings at the plate. One pitch, one out here, bottom of the fourth inning. Babe Ruth dealing since that first inning. Harper, supercharged, at least at the time of recording this video. Last night, just hit 3 homers for his first 3 hits of the year. And we need a double play to have a scoreless bottom of the fourth to get this mercy rule. And that's strike 3, going to be out number 2. 1 out away from a mercy rule. Up to bat now is super fractured Austin Riley. 117th out of 170 people in the world with this card super fractured. And Babe strikes him out. The Cows win. We get the mercy rule in only 4 innings. 11 runs, 13 hits. Those bats didn't really look like bats. They almost looked fake. How many home runs did we have? Mookie Betts had 2. Corey Seager had 2. Christian Yelich had 2. Let's go ahead and check the replay vault and just count our total home runs, though. We had 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 home runs in 4 innings. Now let me show y'all something else. If we go to the batter analysis, we go to all hitters, and we check perfect swings, we can see I had 7 perfects that game. It looks like maybe all of them home runs. And then good swings. In 4 innings, I had 24 good swings. When I was saying that I had at least 6 or 7 foul balls, that if we just have better timing, they might have been home runs, I was not exaggerating. In only 4 innings, that's 24 good swings and 7 perfects. We were just unstoppable at the plate for that entire game. And we're up to 675, 225 points away from World Series, only 25 points away from Division Series, from finally playing some Hall of Fame difficulty games. And Babe is parallel 4. I can't believe we just hit 10 home runs in 4 innings. 7 perfect homers in 4 innings, plus 24 good swings and only 4 good innings. We were just literally on another level at the plate that game. But I hope y'all enjoyed. Like and subscribe. Thank you as always for watching. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you next time.